That was a miss.
A little low.
Just low.
High. Hit. That was a hit for sure.
Yep.
I just heard it.
That was a low was a hit. It just hit the bottom edge.
Bottom?
Bottom edge.
Okay. Right, so it needs to come up a little bit?
Yeah.
Okay.
Your last hit was a little low of center too. Hit.
Nice.
It's a little low and right, little low right corner. That was the hit, middle left.
Got it.
Hit, same spot, last one. Hit, middle, just right of center. Hit, this is low center. Hit, it's almost the same spot as the last.
Nice.
Low center. Hit, middle right. Hit again, center right.
On it.
Nice. Good shooting, man. Damn. That is fairly impressive.
Every hit at 700 yards. Yeah. Once we figured out where the wind was.
Cold and dead on?
No, I'm actually holding off the plate for the wind. Second dot down.
Did better on that one than we did down there on the 300.
Heart rate's not up here, though.
That's impressive.
That gun's amazing, dude. Good ammo, too. We're shooting really good ammo. Yep.
Nice.
Thanks, you're up.
All right.
Look how I get from here. Eric, high again.
Yeah,
a little, just barely. It's hard to tell because I'm not on the same angle as you, but from here it looked a little high.
700 yards. Smith & Wesson M&P10.
That was a hit.
Oh yeah, I heard it.
Nice.
It's a high right corner.
Okay.
Just a little low, I think.
To jerk that one a little bit.
That was dead center.
Nice.
Right in the center of the screen, guys, is where we're shooting.
It's just low right. That looks high.
Yeah. Jerking it.
Where are you aiming with that now, Matt?
Bottom right corner.
Okay, do you want to change your MOA at all?
I should probably come up a little bit.
So you need less or more MOA?
Less. I'm aiming down bottom right, probably 6 inches.
Okay, so you got too much MOA in, right?
Yep.
Okay, so let's go 20. That's 21 MOA right there. And then I would keep aiming right for the wind.
Just a little right.
I would.
There we go.
Tough shooting right here.
Got it. It was low left. But you hit.
Yeah.
And when he hits, just actually, never mind.
Hit center.
Nice.
Just low. Missed it.
Real low. It was hit just the very bottom corner.
So you need some more up or down MOA there, Matt, or
I
no?
I think it's pretty good, man.
Okay, good.
I'm aiming just a shade to the right.
Beautiful. You're doing great. M&P 10.
Just a little right.
Yeah.
And if he hits, let it hit and then tell him where he hit, because you can hear it in the camera.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That hit.
Yeah, I couldn't tell where though. It was hit one of the other spots.
You're on it. Hit
center and just above the midline.
Manipulating that trigger's hard when you're getting this far out.
That's where a match trigger's nice.
Yep. Nice.
Just lower center, a little to the right.
Just missed it. I thought I had that one. I wanted to end on a high note.
Right.
Whew. Longest I've ever shot, that's for sure. And hit something.
Consistent ammunition. Yeah. It's shooting within a 7-inch circle. So we're shooting a Hornady 168 grain AMAX and tactical ammunition 168 grain Nosler. Both are sub MOA loads. The Hornady is shooting a little bit faster, so we have to adjust our MOA on it. But like Matt said, a match trigger here would be really nice to have, because you've got to concentrate with that trigger pull a lot to connect. This shooting rest, it's a Caldwell field pod. It's pretty awesome. It gets us above the sagebrush. We cannot go prone here. We're on a hill and we have brush. It just doesn't work.
Okay, ready to go?
Shooter, send it. This is OJ, M&P10. A little bit to the left, it looked like. Bit just under it, maybe. That's a hit.
Got it. Just to the left.
A little bit left. Are you aiming slightly right?
I am. I'm a little bit more right.
You got some wind down in that valley. Hit.
Got it.
Hit. High. I went right. Hit.
left side. It's about 9 o'clock high on that. Right.
I think that wind must be up and down because I'm aiming the same spot.
Try holding that fore end of way forward, way forward. Get it stable and pull it into your shoulder. Move the rest towards yourself if you need more stability. So get real comfortable with that rest so it's comfortable to you.
Yeah.
Have the rest come to you or you change your position, but it should be real stable. Maybe a little bit right on that one.
Was it? Oh, there we go.
OJ, M&P10.
High left,
looks
I think.
A little bit left, high.
My gun's kind of canted, so. Yeah. Hit. Keep doing what you're doing. Hit. Hit inside 3 o'clock. You got it figured out. Hit. Shoot. Low right. Yeah, about that one.
Still got rounds, you out.
Got more. Couple more.
Low right.
Good shooting, man.
I could feel when it was stable, I was hitting, and then when I was getting a little unstable here.
What's that?
When it was stable, I was hitting, and then I was getting a little unstable a couple times.
Well, the thing is, at this yardage, any micro movement is unforgiving.
And if I take the time to kind of adjust the height, because I'm a little cramped down here, but I'm still hitting.
Yeah, but let's do it next time. I mean, we can lower those legs for you since, how tall are you, 5'3"?
Yeah, probably better, a little bit higher.
So tell the audience what it's like shooting this far. A lot of them will never be able to do it, both you guys.
That's a lot of fun, yeah, I mean.
Tell them.
A lot of fun at this distance. I mean, you can pull the trigger and you kind of know before it even hits whether you hit or not, or you have a good idea. It's enough distance that you can take a look at your target and at this distance, if you don't see dirt fly, then you know you hit it.
Can you imagine doing this in combat?
Yeah, something moving, it's going to be a little tougher. You know, hopefully you'd be able to hit something that's not moving. But
honestly, in my opinion, you'd be doing it probably from bipod. Probably from a hidden precision rifle type thing, like a sniper environment. Shooting on the move, running gun this distance, forget it. I don't think you're gonna hit. Your heart rate's too high.
Yeah. A lot of the...
Unless you train and train and train and train.
A lot of the SWAT snipers I train with will train at long distances, but the reality is that urban shootings are about average of 75 yards, and so these distances are not realistic engagements for SWAT officers.
What do you think, Matt? Let me film you.
Well, I'm thoroughly impressed, man. Well, that's a hard shot, even with the bolt gun. I'm surprised.
And we're here with an 18-inch 308 gas gun.
I mean, you guys shot better than I did, but, I mean, you were spot on. I mean, we all got hits. You got more. You guys got more than me.
I want to go through another mag, each of us. You guys up for it?
Absolutely.
It takes a bit of concentration staying off for 20 rounds, don't it?
Yeah. Squeezing that trigger real slow, and everything's kind of moving around, and I'm having a little trouble getting my head close enough to the glass to get it to be a perfect circle. Sometimes that's excuse, you know. But
Before you shoot next time, both y'all take some time and get that set up for you need it. Ideally, we'd have a bipod or whatever, but this works good. It's obviously stable enough.
Yeah. I mean, so what is it, 703 yards? Is that what you said?
It is 707. We're shooting at 707 yards with a Smith & Wesson M&P10. Gas gun.
Yeah, and so much for the barrel heating up and it not, and when we talked about that, and
I ain't seen it, are you?
Clearly that's not the case.
I just put 60 rounds through right now and it was still hitting, so.
Yeah, so I'm thoroughly impressed. Non-free float barrel. Non-match trigger.
Your Brazilian fans will like that.
We got a few. Three of them. Yeah, that's out of the box. You put it'll be even easier with a nice trigger on it. And then free float.
Float the barrel,
It's cool. Okay, I'm go time. Brief me on the reticle where you're shooting now.
I was holding just a little one-third down. I
was doing the same thing.
One-third down and just about a third to the right of the target. Yeah. Maybe just on the edge.
I was aiming pretty close to the bottom.
That's
right corner.
That's going, by the way.
Oh.
That's doing the
crotch shot. Got a couple crotch shots there.
Something tells you that was intentional from Jerry.
I heard stories, man.
What were you saying now for shooting?
Bottom right corner is pretty much where
I'll start there. You guys can walk me on. I put a new battery in that.
Okay. If you want to do that on this. Yep.
Well, yeah, it looks like a freaking firefight's gone on over here.
Hey, you're running low on battery on this bad boy. You got a spare?
Well, I guess that was loaded. All right, let me put a new one in right now. We're shooting. Dang, I did that again.
Little low. Hit. Couldn't tell where. Hit.
It was just that was a hit?
Yep, just a little high of center and to the right. Just a little low. Low right corner.
Bottom right?
Yep.
I'll come up a little bit there.
That's right. Pretty much just center and little above midline.
What?
It was a center and a little above midline.
Perfect.
It's a little low. Again. Hit and just a little low and right. Hit right in the esophagus area, center and high. Hit, I couldn't tell where. I think that was just a little high and right. It's hit and pretty much dead center. Hit, couldn't quite tell where. It was hit again as a lower edge. Hit, I think it was a lower edge again.
Nice shooting, boss.
It takes a lot of concentration staying in the glass that long. I'm aiming upper right shoulder to compensate for the wind. You can see as you hit it, the dust and any miss, you can see the drift. Not a ton of wind, a little bit.
Yeah, aiming upper right corner?
Upper right shoulder is where I was aiming this probably last 10 rounds.
And we had, what, two or three misses out of all those?
I'm happy. Happy with the gun, happy with the shooting. You're up, Mr. Matt.
All right, man.
He won a long range. He's getting it.
Yep.
In TMP.
Right. I got to try to do better than you just did, man. I don't know if that's possible.
I like that spirit. Not a single malfunction all day.
Nope.
Have you seen one?
None.
We've ran two M&P10s and they've been 100%.
Got to be at probably 300-400 rounds.
Well, by the time this is all done, 500 round shot. Around there.
This is it.
This is it. This is your time for glory.
Yeah.
Losing light fast here. Yeah. Getting colder. Matt Skutnik from Smith & Wesson demoing the M&P10.
It was a hit. I couldn't tell where, but it was a hit.
Hit.
Hit again. Again, I can't tell where.
No.
707 yards. No lie.
It was a hit in the upper right corner.
High right, that was me.
Little to the high and right. The little right. High. little high, a little to the right.
That was it.
That was a hit.
Now I'm dead on. I think the wind's changing a little down there.
You can see it when it hits, right, Matt? You'll see the splatter.
Yeah. That one I just held spot on.
That was a hit. It's a little high, high and right. Go high and right again. Go high and right again. Go high and right again.
If I were to blame something, it'd probably be your trigger pulls.
Yeah.
You got to do a real dedicated smooth trigger pull on that. Like I was saying, anything, any jerk will miss the shot for you.
It was hitting the upper right corner.
Yeah, that was it.
As a hit, couldn't tell where.
Do you have sunglasses on, Matt?
They're transitions.
You might want to take them off.
They're all dark.
That might help.
Yeah. There. Come on. They're prescriptions, man.
Are they?
Yeah. That was kind of help a little bit, though.
That was a hit. Hit. Drop. Center a little high.
That was me.
It was a little low and right.
That was
a hit.
Good. Good way to end.
Good.
Woo. Not bad. All the misses were my fault.
Oh. OJ, you want one more?
Sure.
That's a spirit. I'll try to edit this down. Yeah. We haven't let the barrel cool at all, dude.
It's pretty toasty.
It feels good in the cold.
Does actually.
That's like a hand heater.
Move out, man. Take turns, man.
Is it warm?
It is. Oh, that feels good, man. Your trigger finger gets cold.
It's cold. You can't shoot with fat gloves out here. OJ's running pigs. I'm running 0.5 mechanics.
One of those is kind of empty. Yeah.
These are pretty good gloves.
This one feels cool.
Digging them.
Hit. Don't know where. Looks like dead buck dead center. Look just a little to the right. Hit. Just to the right. Just to the right again. Got it.
That's a hit. Keep doing what you just did.
To the right. Just to the right again, I think.
Huh.
Could be just under.
Oh, that's okay. Mm-hmm. We're good with that. I got enough footage. You can pull that off and spot through, though. Let me wiggle this off. Hold it.
Yep.
Hold on, Jared. Spotter's coming on.
Just look off to the right. Low and to the right. Got it. Hit. Hit. Hi. Got it. Got it. Got it. I'm shooting.
Finish strong, dude.
Good times.
Good shooting, OJ.
Flinking steel at 700.
With a direct gas impingement, 308 AR-15. Good times.
Yep.
Nutnfancy Project, Matt from Smith & Wesson. Thanks for coming out, bro.
Thanks for having me, man.
It's great for host.
Good to be back.
It was great hosting you. Thanks for coming out.
Yeah. Got to do it again, too.
Thanks for building cool guns like this. The only thing I would say is put a freaking free float tube on it, Troy Alpha rail, maybe a mid-profile barrel that's fluted.
I agree.
The gun as it is great.
Yeah.
But that would be another great version to have. I wouldn't change the gas system. I wouldn't change the barrel length.
Nope.
The barrel length you got right.
Yeah.
18 is perfect. 18
is good.
Perfect. Signing off from a cold hillside as it gets dark.
Yeah.
Officer Jared, Matt Skutnik, Nutnfancy. See ya. Peace.